Hello students, today let us see a topic, partial order relations in the unit lattices Boolean algebra in the subject discrete mathematics. And here we are going to see a property from this topic. And this is a property: suppose R is a partial order relation on a set A, then R inverse is also a partial order relation on the same set. The same question may be given in this way: if A comma R is a partially ordered set, then A comma R inverse is also a partial order set. So R inverse is defined in this way: set of all ordered pair A comma B whenever B comma A belongs to R. So to prove it is partial order relation, we have to prove reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive. So first let us start the reflexive property. Let us take A is an element in the set A, and let us prove A comma A belongs to R inverse, that is R inverse is reflexive. Let us prove. So when we say A belongs to A, R is a partial order relation on that set. So in particular, R is reflexive. Partial order relation means reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive. So R is reflexive. So when we say R is reflexive, A comma A belongs to R. When A comma B comma A belongs to R, it's reverse: A comma B belongs to R inverse. So when A comma A belongs to R, it's reverse: A comma A belongs to R inverse. This is what we are expected to prove. So R inverse is reflexive. And let us prove antisymmetric. That is, whenever A comma B and B comma A both are in R inverse, we are supposed to prove A equal to B. Now A comma B and B comma A both are in R inverse. So whenever A comma B belongs to R inverse, look at the definition. B comma A belongs to R means it's reverse: A comma B belongs to R inverse. So A comma B belongs to R inverse means it's reverse: B comma A belongs to R. Similarly, B comma A belongs to R inverse, that is taken. B comma A belongs to R inverse, that is we have assumed. So it's reverse: A comma B belongs to R. Now we have this relation: A comma B and B comma A both are in R. R is a partial order relation, and in particular R is antisymmetric. So we got A equal to B by the definition of antisymmetric relation. So whenever both AB and BA are in R, A equal to B. So this is what we are supposed to prove. So R inverse is antisymmetric. Now transitive: A comma B belongs to R inverse, B comma C belongs to R inverse. We are supposed to prove A comma C belongs to R inverse. So A comma B belongs to R inverse. So it's reverse: B comma A belongs to R. B comma C belongs to R inverse. So it's reverse: C comma B belongs to R. Now rewrite this in this way: C comma B belongs to R, B comma A belongs to R. So C is related to B, B is related to A. So when we combine using transitive relation, R is a partial order relation, so R is transitive in particular. So using transitive relation, C is related to B, B is related to A, so C is related to A. So C comma A belongs to R. It's reverse: A comma C belongs to R inverse. This is what we are supposed to prove. A B belongs to R inverse, B C belongs to R inverse, A C belongs to R inverse. This is what we are supposed to prove. R inverse is transitive. So reflexive, antisymmetric, transitive relation is called partial order relation. So the set is called partial ordered set with respect to the relation R inverse. This is what we are supposed to prove. So with this, the problem is over. Now let us see another problem in the next video. Thank you.